Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. Well, as you know, maybe in War Thunder I have neglected the Russian planes for the longest time. I have researched a few of them, but that came from my period of realistic battles back in the day, 2014 and 15, and I never really touched this research tree again. But after a little bit of research, I decided to give it another go, mainly because of this, but we will come to this later. So I had two matches yesterday. One was in the Yak-9U, which I have this beautiful skin for. I think it looks really nice. It has a 5.0 battle rating, and I took this up to tier 4 to get the points for this. I bought this, it's the LA-11, the Lavochkin 11, it's a premium plane, sitting at 6.0 BR. And I took this at first to try it out. I took it out in RB. And what can I say? It's in RB really underwhelming. Everything climbs better, everything, not everything, but almost everything dives better. When you are side climbing, as usual in RB, you see that basically all the enemies are above you. P-47s get an air spawn, so they are above you. Spitfires can climb better and are faster, so they are above you. You have a really hard time in that thing, in RB. But in SB, the so-called meta, is different. Why did I purchase this plane? Let's explain this first. I read a little bit about this on Wikipedia and a few other pages in the internet. And I can say that it is an interesting plane. I see it as basically the Russian attempt to a P-51. Why did I think this? Well, first, it has laminar flow wings, right? That's the exact same thing as on the P-51s. So they have the same structure, or the same form, shape rather. It's optimized for high speeds, right? So you can see this is basically the same wing. Put this side by side again, you can see almost the same. What it lacks though is engine performance. It has the web performance is 1800 horsepower, and the other P-51 sitting at 6.3, so basically the same bracket, that can put out a whopping 2239 horsepower. So that's the difference. The P-51, especially the H-5, but also the D-30, is faster than the Lavochkin LA-11. But still, it is very interesting. Well, first, it's the last of the piston engine fighters of the Soviet Union. After that, only jets came. So that's really the last production model. It was, I think, introduced in 1947, so 2 years after World War II ended, and over 1,000 were still produced. Also, a few were given to the Chinese Air Force, and I think North Korea and all the communist satellite states, whatever. And it introduced not only the laminar flow wing, but also a few things in the cockpit. So let's have a look at the cockpit first. Go this, this. So, what can we see? Not so much, because I don't have track IR enabled at the moment. But what can you see? It's relatively ergonomically, right? It's ergonomically designed. That was a first in the Soviet Air Force. Also, it has something like pilot heating, so a heating system for the pilot. It has advanced equipment for communication and navigation. So basically all the tech that has gone, what was developed up until this time, up until 1947, was introduced in here first. So everything a prop plane could feature technologically was made possible with this plane. I like how the cockpit looks. It also has a gyroscopic gun sight. This is of course of limited use in War Thunder, since it's not really adjustable for range, etc. But it's there. If you want to use it, it's there. Also, you can basically whip this thing forever. It does not overheat. Then let's talk about the armament. It has three 23 NS-23 machine cannons in the nose, and they pack quite a punch. When you hit something with this, even after the nerf, I know that the NS-23 has been nerfed a little bit in War Thunder, but there are three of that, and if you hit properly, you will definitely do some serious damage. So what did I found out? When you fly this, you have to be at altitude. Not surprising, but you really have to. You can't outclimb the enemy. It has a 16.1 meter per second climb rate, a 3.3 or 3.0 even, 109 F2 can outclimb that thing with 20 meters per second. So you have to be at altitude. You have to keep your energy high, very high. You can't outturn things. It has 22 second turn time, and that is absolutely true. You can't really tweak this in any way with your rudder or whatever. You are not going to turn very well. Everything is outturning you. A 109, a P-51, a P-39, especially the Japanese planes, J-2Ms, A-6Ms, yeah, you name it. Everything is going to outturn you. So the only thing that you really have is your energy. Why is it then at 6.0 with this kind of stats? It should rather be at, I don't know, 5.0 maybe? Good question, ask Gaijin, I have no idea. It has no real advantage, it's just an interesting plane for plane nerds like me. Because, like I said, it's the last prop fighter of the Soviet Union. Also, it's relatively expensive, at least where I live. It's €29.90, I think. You get with this the plane, 1,000 Golden Eagles and 15 days of premium. If that's worth it to you, I don't know. If you only fly RB, no. If you only fly AB, definitely not. If you fly simulator like me, yes, because there it can kinda fit its role as a high altitude bomber escort. That was the intentional role of this thing. So basically what you can do is go up high and keep your energy up and do your thing up there. It's not a turn and burner, it's not really a turn fighter, it's not a really good climber. It can do nothing really well except shoot things. So if you get your guns on target, you will do damage. So without further talking, you know I'm a plane nerd, I have to do this from time to time. So without further talking, I will throw you into the replay of first the Yak-9U. I wanted to train this a little bit. I had a few incidents where my guns did not really hit. So I admit, with the Russian guns, I still have my problems. I will never be really good in this. You know I can aim the 50 kills. You know I can aim the MG-151s, even the MK-108 or 103s. Relatively good, but the Shvaks and the NS-23s and the other thing, the 37mm of the Russians, I'm not really fond of them. Not yet, at least. But still, the matches I had were rather successful. As I said, first I got the Yak-9U. With this nice skin to get the points for the LA-11, and then I took to the skies on this until the next one.